So in this video, we're going to discuss about users. Again, I can click on the dashboard or just go to the users up here. So what do we see here? We have mobile workers, groups, web apps permission, and then we have project users, which are web users and roles, and then organization. So groups, web app permissions, organization, and organizational levels and structure, we're going to discuss in a later module. For now, we're just going to look again at creating mobile workers and then a little bit at web users and roles. Okay, great. So remember, we created the tester account. When we start collecting actual data, we obviously need to create new usernames. So in my case, I'm going to create a username, and usually our convention is the first letter of the first name and then the surname, so R. Myers in this case, and then we can write out the mobile worker's name and a password. Great, so preferably you would create a mobile worker, create a mobile worker username and password for every single mobile worker that is going to partake in your survey, for example. So we can create another user here. Oops. So Alex and Tran, and again, a password. And so on and so forth. And again, a password. So for this exercise, maybe you can create, you know, one or two or even three mobile workers, and then these can be used for the actual data collection. So when we get to the Power BI bit, we will filter out all the tester data and leave in the data collected by the actual data collectors. So it's very important that when you're doing the trainings with the mobile workers or your enumerators, that at first you give them the tester account to, you know, try out the application, and then just before they leave, you enter their actual username and password together with them, so that they're all set up and ready to go possibly the next day. Now, if I want to have a quick look at my mobile workers, just an overview, I can use this button here, Download Mobile Workers. Just click on Download Users and open it up. Great, and so here I can see I have a little overview of all the different users. Their passwords are obviously hidden, their names, and then we can add things like phone numbers, emails. Everybody has a unique user ID, and whether or not the user is active or inactive. Now, we need to take care when a mobile worker, for example, has stopped or the survey has come to an end, we don't want them to enter any more data. In that case, we can, when we go to mobile workers, we can deactivate them simply by pressing here. So let's deactivate Alex Tran, for example. Okay, great. So he cannot now log in anymore. There is a difference between deactivating and deleting mobile workers. So in permanent actions, it's possible to delete a mobile worker. And as you can see, there are some caveats here. So they won't be able to sync or submit any data, and it's going to delete all of their form submissions. So this is a bit tricky, and this action is permanent as well. So we cannot, you know, call ComCare after and ask them to upload the forms again. It's going to delete all of Alex Trans's form submissions. So it's not often that we would use this. We would almost always just deactivate the user. And so here we can define some more options for the user when we go to basic. So role, there is no role now because they're a mobile user, but we can enter their email address, we can select a language for them, and we can even add a phone number. As I said, groups, this we'll discuss in a later module. And then here we can also create a new password for this mobile worker. And so finally, on mobile workers, there's this option for edit user fields. So here we can add additional user properties. So for example, we could add something like age, or if you're working across multiple countries, we could add the country property. So this is going to be the actual property name, like the question ID, the label, which I'll just name the same. And then we can make it required. We can say, hey, do you need to specify the country when you create a new mobile worker, yes or no? So let's say yes. And then we can add the choices. So we can here add the different countries that we work in. So here's three examples. And then we can save these fields, and we can come back later and add more choices if we want. So let's just save. So let's return to mobile workers. And so now if we create a mobile worker, Amanda Agar, for example, set up a password, and then here we need to select a country for them. And there's our new mobile worker with a country assigned as one of the properties. And then we have our web users and roles. So web user is something else. You at this very moment are a web user. And if you created this project space, you are actually an admin. So that's what we see here. I see my email address and then my role as an admin. But I can also invite other people. So I can invite Alex. Sorry, so that would be atran@goal.ie. And I can define their project role. So I can make them admin, I can make them app editor, billing admin, field implementer, or just a read-only account. So read-only accounts are very useful if we want to give them access to Power BI, for example, but not actually be able to mess around with the applications that we created or the other exports. So if I send an invite, he will get an email inviting him to this project space, and then he can join. And then again, I can delete the invitation, or I can delete the user himself. So, and here we see what the different roles are. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 standard roles, and they all are able to do different things. So an app editor, for example, is only allowed to edit apps and view reports. Whereas the billing admin can edit the subscription info, but can't actually do anything else. The field implementer can edit mobile workers, edit locations, and view the reports. And a read-only account can only view the reports. And we can add roles. So, you know, this can be whatever. You can come up with something creative. And then here are all the options for what they're able to do. Editing data, editing locations, editing mobile workers, viewing reports. And then here we can select the specific reports that they're able to view or not view. Select the landing page. Do they land on a dashboard or in web apps or in reports? And some other options here. So allowing them to send an error report to Demagi, and then allow non-admins to assign this role to other users. So maybe, you know, we can have like a field implementer assistant or something, and we want to allow field implementers to create these kind of roles, or to invite people to become that role.